All right. I asked the question, who likes three-piece tuna or hot tuna with friends? And the response went off the wall. So many people answered, and it was great, you know. But I have to say, you know, just having Yama and Jack any way we can get them is fantastic. There is no better musicians out there. When Yama picks up his guitar and Jack picks up his bass, they aren't they aren't instruments. They become like another part of their body, another limb. I mean, for a guy that's 75 years old to hold this thing for as long as he did on stage Friday and Saturday night, that alone is amazing. This guitar's not light, man. It's not, you know, and Yama is conditioned, and now I realize why he tours every week, month after month after month, because that's what the man loves to do. He loves to play for his fans. And Jack also. I mean, Jack's not a youngster either. That guy is all over the stage. He's a madman, Jack. You know, and his bass solos were incredible. Hot Tuna today can hold up to any band out there and kick ass. And musician-wise, these guys are top-notch. It's unreal. Saturday night's show, though, the sound was cranked. That was the first Hot Tuna show I've been to in years that my ears were buzzing. They really were. I mean, I was in the seventh row, and it was incredible. Friday night, it wasn't as loud. It really wasn't. You know, when you turn the volume up, you get a different vibe. The music goes through you. It really. And on Friday night, Yama was talking a lot, and whoever was doing sound, it was muffled because I didn't understand a word he was saying in between songs. And I was in the front row. I didn't understand the word the man said. You know, and you know, the music was great on Friday night, but his vocals were muffled bad. But on Saturday night, it was a whole new story. That sound guy was fantastic, man. You know, America's Choice, it says, this album should be played at full volume for maximum effect. Goes for all Hot Tuna music. All Hot Tuna music should be cranked. There's no question. I only hope that next year, Yama and Jack do a tour of three-piece, because from reading all of what everybody says, it is totally clear that Hot Tuna's fan base wants three-piece tuna. A lot of us like your friends, but we love three-piece tuna. There is something magical that happens when Yama, Jack, and a drummer plays. You know, I would love to see Bob Steele do a tour with Jack and Yama again. It would be fantastic. After all these years, those guys get back together. Nothing against you, Justin. You're fantastic, man. It's just that it's a part of their history, and we would love to see Bob Steele back with Yama and Jack, at least do a few shows. It would be great. And we miss Papa John. Papa John, no question about it. And even bring Michael Fazzaranzo back for a few shows with you guys, man, because Michael Fazzaranzo is Hot Tuna also from the 70s and 80s, you know, and 90s. You know, it was great, but thank God that we got Hot Tuna today. We really do. We should be grateful for that, you know. And we should take them any way we can, you know. And when Yama and Jack play just acoustic, again, it is unreal. Yama, I will say it again. Yama is the only guy that can play to a few thousand people and get the guy in the back row to say, this guy's unfucking real. There's not many guitarists that can do that. You know, finally we got Yama to play acoustic again, and we got three-piece Hot Tuna again, and it is fucking great. And I want to thank you guys. I love you all. I'll talk to you all real soon. Bye-bye.